Please welcome to the stage, Nick T.
All right, thank you. Yeah, this is my first time. Enjoying myself already. I definitely like the applause before I've done anything of significance. That's pretty cool. Makes me think Trump's America might work out after all. Yeah, you guys, some of you didn't think it was going to get that political that early. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, but I've been thinking about Spider-Man a lot lately, like I do. And I'm thinking about the scene theme song, the 60s theme song. You remember it. Spider-Man can do whatever a spider can, right? Well, I've been thinking about the second verse of that song, which goes a little something like one guy asking, is he strong? To which guy two responds, listen, bud, he's got radioactive blood. And I've always thought, like, that is not really an answer to that question. That is a very strange dodge. That guy does not want to talk about Spider-Man anymore. That first guy, he is badgering this guy all day about Spider-Man. Hey, is he strong? Listen, buddy, he's got radioactive blood. Does he have the other abilities? Does he have legs? It's like, listen, bud, he has radioactive blood. I can't say it any more ways than that. Yeah, but, like, does it affect his sexuality? Like, can he get it up? Like, is it vulnerable? Like, listen, bud, he's got radioactive blood. Listen, bud, he's got radioactive blood. It's such a weak dodge that I'm surprised Sean Spicer does not use it in a press briefing. Mr. Spicer, would you like to comment on Trump's, comments about the, nuclear threats coming from Kim Jong-un? Listen, bud, what you don't understand is that Kim Jong-un, he actually has radioactive blood, and that's significant because even Hitler didn't have radioactive blood. Nailed it. keep that up and you'll be working in this administration forever. You know what I really love about politics nowadays is that people almost care about it as much as Game of Thrones politics. Like, we're not there yet, but a couple more Nazi rallies and maybe a little bit more Ivanka and Donald Trump, that gets a little more incestuous. I think we're at Game of Thrones. It got to the point where one of my friends, that might be sitting in this room actually, his mom was a Trump supporter, and they've had many an argument, but they're both Game of Thrones fans, and instead of letting that be a common bond, they decided to destroy one another. And I helped, because he came to me, and he said, like, hey, you know how I'm stealing your HBO password? And I'm like, no, well, surprise. But I need your help on this one. Like, let that one slide. And so, his plan, Game of Thrones, we had the finale the previous season, and he let it run all the way up to the finale until about right about where it was going to drop, right at the start, and then he texted me when his mom and him sat down to watch it, and he said, like, okay, change the password. And he refreshes it, and it comes up, mom doesn't know what to do, she's clicking the clicker, and then he leans over and goes, Lannister sent their regards. Now, the funny part of that story is he calls me a week later, dude, I forgot the password you switched it to. Can I get that back? Like, I don't remember the password. And I'm like, the North remembers. Click. It's been a great time. I also wanted to mention that another movie that I've seen recently was the Emoji Movie. And that really pissed me off. And the reason why is that from the trailer, I haven't seen it. I assume it's terrible, and I feel like even though my opinion is ignorant, it is still justified and correct. The trailer mentions that they're in a room where emojis that don't get used hang out, and there's an eggplant emoji in the background. I've accepted a lot of unbelievable things in my films. That people can jump through windows and not get ripped to shreds, or can shoot locks off doors, or that Christian Slater is somehow an actor. But if you're telling me that a teenager's phone is not blowing up with eggplant emojis, that's a step too far, sir. Step too far, Sony. What am I supposed to believe, that his older brother in college isn't sending dick pics at all? Where is the line? I believe that is my time. I'm going to give it up to another equally funny person, and I know what you're thinking. How do I know that? Because I don't even know who's going after me. Well, so my response is, listen, bud, he's got radioactive blood.